Frida Kahlo. Just kidding, it's me, Frida Kahlo. I got you, didn't I? You thought that was me, but no. That's a picture that I made, and this is me. Picture me.
Some of you babies maybe know me because your parents are like super duper art cool Brooklyn parents. Nice going parents. I'm proud of you. I'm super famous for painting me.
I have a super special guest here today, but he's a little bit shy. So on the count of three, we're all going to call out Monkey. Can you guys do that? Okay. One, two, three. Monkey. Monkey's name is Mo Problems because Mo Monkey, Mo Problems. And there's a lot of monkey. Can you guys say Mo Monkey, Mo Problems?
Mo Monkey, Mo Problems.
Nice. Okay, so today we're going to be learning some Spanish together. And Monkey's going to help me, right, Monkey? And the first word we're going to learn is actor. An actor is like somebody who puts on like weird clothes and like makeup and things, and then they go on the stage and they're like blah 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 blah, but it's like somebody else wrote the words usually. They tell like a story. For example, no, I can't fix your toilet, I'm an actor. The English word for actor is actor. Oh, it's the same. You did not tell me that earlier. Oh my god, stop, you're embarrassing me in front of my friends. The next word that we're going to learn is director. For example, wow, you're being super bossy. Yeah, I know I'm being super bossy, I'm a director. The English word for director is director. Okay, I got it. The next word is a drama. Super emotional, and sometimes people are kissing. I know, super gross. And sometimes people are crying. For example, stop laughing at my one-woman show. It's a drama. The English word for drama is drama. Yeah, it's the same again. Let me think one second.
Material.
Taxi.
Vital.
Universal.
Unión. Exposición. Tropical.
Terrible.
Okay, Monkey, what should I teach them? Oh, that's a great idea, Monkey. Thank you. Oh, I just kissed you a little bit. The word we are going to learn today is abrazo, which means hug. For example, I would hug you, but there's like a lot of things going on right now with the social distancing, so instead I'm just gonna stand over here and go like, which is my version of a hug. Abrazo means hug. When you reach your arms out like this and you wrap them around a friend. Wait, where did he go?
Abrazo.
Clem Karaoke.
Hi everyone, and welcome to this week's episode of Clem Karaoke. I'm Hope Finnick, and
I'm Clementine.
So on this week's episode, I'm gonna switch it up a little bit, and I'm gonna teach you guys some very special singing exercises that I learned in school. And that way we can become better singers together during this quarantine. So the exercise we're gonna learn today is lip trills.
Lip trills?
Yeah, lip trills. Have you ever blown air through your lips when you're bored like this? Yes, I have. Me too. Did you know that that actually is one of the best singing exercises ever?
How so?
Well, I'll tell you. Our first exercise is a non-vocalized lip trill, like this. And this exercise can really, really help you with your breathing while you sing. Our next exercise is a vocalized lip trill, like this. So, now that we're all warmed up and ready, let's sing. This week, we're gonna sing What a Wonderful World by Louis Armstrong. you can go ahead and follow the lyrics and sing along with me and Clementine. The part of the song that we're gonna sing starts here. Ready? I see trees of green, red roses too. I see them bloom for me and you. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. Great job, everyone. That sounded awesome. Stay safe, stay hopeful, and stay healthy. Bye, everyone. High five.
Hey everybody, welcome to PRL, Puppet Request Live. I'm your host, the infamous Drake. Great to have you here. Today's hit song is by Post Malone. You know, the whole reason why the rap game is singing right now is because of me. But Post, he's a good singer, man. Let's hear it. This song is called Circles. Seasons change, and our love went cold. Now, this may seem obvious, but this song is about circles. That's right. So let's practice our shapes. Can you draw a circle? You could do it with a crayon and paper, or you could just use your finger. If you're trying to get really crazy, man, you could just spin around in circles like, whoa. But man, this song has a beautiful message. It really helped me through a breakup. He says, seasons change and our love went cold. Feed the flame because we can't let go. It's tragic. You know, he's talking about how he wants to keep his love alive. Feed the flame because it's hard to let go once you love someone. He's in there deep, man. Then he says we're running in circles. Run away, run away. So he knows that he's following unhealthy patterns, but they're running in circles. So he's got to instead run away, yo. Like hashtag YOLO. That relationship sounds toxic. Finally, I want to talk about Post Malone's look. He's got a really unique look. You know, he's got some facial tattoos, just like Harley Quinn. And look, while we're practicing shapes, what shape does she have on her face? That's right, it's a heart. And our friend Post Malone also has what we call grills. Can you say grills? Those are the sparkly diamonds on his teeth. Grills. All right, that's it for today. But you know, we always love to hear from the fans. So tag us in photos of circles that you drew or shoot a video showing us your grills. That's right. See you next time at Puppet Request Live, PRL. Man, look at how good that circle is. Bet you didn't think a puppet could draw a circle like that.
Hey everyone, and welcome to Carol with Colors. My name is Caroline, and this is where we draw something together. Today, I actually have a special request. So, my teddy bears have been asking me to draw their picture, and I thought you all at home could help me. What do you think? Yeah? I thought we could make a teddy bear! Yes! So all you will need will be a piece of paper to draw on and something to draw with. So that could be a crayon or colored pencil, or even a regular pencil or pen. I'm gonna use markers because I think that might be a little bit easier for you all to see my lines. Should we get started?
First, I'm gonna start with my black marker to draw the outside lines of our teddy bear. So first, we're gonna draw one big circle for our teddy bear's head. There we go, just like that. And now we're gonna draw two upside down C's to make the teddy bear's ears. We go one on the left, boom, and one on the right. Okay, And then we're gonna draw two smaller ones inside of these ears, like this, a little bit smaller. There we go. Okay, and now we have to draw the teddy bear's arm. So we're gonna make a big hook. It's sort of like a backwards L. We're gonna draw from the bottom of the head, and we're gonna go like this. You see? A big hook. And we're gonna round it out with a circle, a little round, as if you're making a circle, and we're gonna bring it back. And then, after we've drawn this line here, we're gonna draw just a little line there. So that makes the teddy bear's arm. And then, my teddy bear here has a little heart, so I'm gonna draw a heart too. So I'm gonna say, just like, little heart. So my teddy bear's holding a heart. Now I'm gonna go on the opposite side and draw just a little baby arc, just like that, okay? And now I'm gonna work on the other arm of my teddy bear. So I'm gonna draw a straight line going towards the left, like that. And then it rounds out with a half circle there. And then we're gonna draw a final long line right like that, okay? So that is, those are both of our arms, and now we have to draw our legs. So we're gonna draw one line coming from straight down from our arm. So we're gonna go like this, just a straight line, and at the end of our straight line, we're gonna curve it, another little curve, and we're gonna make another line go straight back up, and we're gonna make a really big curve here, like this. Boom, big curve, okay? And then we're gonna finish by curving our bottom. This is our second leg here. And then we drag a follow line all the way up there. Okay? And last but not least, we're gonna put two little arcs right here. Boom. We'll do a little arc right here. All right, so that is the big body of our teddy bear. And we're gonna finish with our teddy bear's face. So we're gonna draw one more small circle at the very bottom of our big head, and then we're gonna draw a little triangle here and a line coming down from the triangle, and then one big smile, just like that, right? That's like a little big smile. And of course our teddy bear needs eyes, so we go boom, boom. So there we go. That is how we draw a teddy bear.
You guys did such an awesome job. Thank you for joining me on Caro with Colors. I cannot wait to see your teddy bear pictures, so make sure you share with us on @Puppetsburg. You can tag us or message us your pictures. We would love to see them. And if you have any suggestions for what we should draw in the future, make sure you reach out. Thank you guys so much and have such an awesome day. Mwah.
Roses are red, violets are silk. Nothing tastes better with cereal than milk.
Shakespeare Shakedown with Rhonda the Flamingo.
Welcome, everyone, to Shakespeare Did you guys hear that? I think
that might be someone you know.
This is Shakespeare Did somebody say Shakespeare? Yes, I did, Rhonda. Well, excuse me, Lily, but I am Rhonda the Flamingo, and I have a master's degree. Okay, Rhonda. Every episode, I'm going to teach you one thing about Shakespeare.
And then what will you do, Rhonda?
And then I will allow you to witness my performance. And then we will discover the little Shakespeare master in you. I was thinking we could start with iambic pentameter.
Iambic pentameter.
pentameter. Iambic means that there are iambic feet, just like my feet here, in the line. And penta means, I know penta like my house. No. Penta is the Latin for five. Oh. Will everyone find their hand? Did you bring a hand today? Put your hand on your heart like Lily here, okay? Oh, I feel it. Ba-bump, 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 ba-bump. Yes, exactly. Very good. Now, did you know that beat of your heart is the same beat as iambic pentameter? Shall I compare thee to a summer's day? Rhonda, do you think maybe it's time to actually perform? Oh, of course! Shall I compare thee to a summer's day? Thou art more lovely and more temperate. Rough winds do shake the darling buds of May, and summer's lease hath all too short a date. Okay, Rhonda, I think that's all we have time for. Okay, fine. Repeat after me. Rough winds. Do shake. The darling. Buds of May. Take some time to say it to yourself. Okay, like how? Loud, as if you are talking to your friend across a large, large lake. Rough winds do shake the darling buds of May. You try it out. Yes. Beautiful, that sounds great. I believe that's all we have time for today. Okay, Rhonda, I'm really looking forward to more. They should record themselves and then tag at Puppetsburg and repost it on Instagram. Thank you so much for joining us here at Rhonda's Shakespeare Shakedown. Congratulations.